I'd like to thank you all for joining us in the Fleck Dance Theatre for the Pan Canada benefit. Special welcome to the Right Honourable Adrian Clarkson, an esteemed patron Pan Canada, and to members of the King family. We're very pleased to have you all with us tonight. Pan Canada's One Humanity Award is given to writers whose work transcends national divides and inspires connections across cultures.
This year's winner, the Vietnamese blogger Nguyen Van Hai, better known for his nom de guerre Du K, extends this tradition of unshakable courage. The One Humanity Award pays tribute to these bloggers, and it's intended to be a modest acknowledgement of remarkable courage and tenacity that Du K has shown in the face of fearful odds. Chi Dang is going to accept the award on behalf of Du K's family.
As we are gathering here tonight, in Vietnam, Du K's son and his wife are traveling the distance to visit him in prison. So news of tonight's benefit and Du K being Pan Canada's this year One Humanity Award have reached him. On behalf of Du K and on behalf of all of the human rights activists who are standing strong all around the world, and especially to Pan Canada, thank you so much again.
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Stephen King.
What really started this book going for me, the ignition key that turned on the motor, was I saw a story about a cat named Oscar in Rhode Island. And Oscar has apparently helped over 50 patients die. He knows when they're going to pass away. And he goes into their rooms and jumps up on the bed and spends time with him before they die, which they usually do within the course of 12 hours. And that interested me because I have that kind of mind. You can call it morbid if you want to. Hey, it's made a lot of money, so what can I say? You know, people go to a psychiatrist and they spend $90, $100 an hour to talk about their fears. I write them down, people pay me. It's a great way to roll.
Thank you so much. It's an honor to be here to support Pen Canada and to read with my dad. So the scene that I'm going to read, it's appropriate that I should be reading this for a Pen audience because I know nothing can shock you. They had been having semi-regular phone sex. Sam was careful not to probe too eagerly into the matter of whom besides her parents she had been spending time with, and he was deliberately vague about his own spare hours, not least because there was mortifyingly little to reveal. Since graduating and moving to the apartment, Sam hadn't done much except work on the script and watch movies checked out from the library. He certainly hadn't been getting laid. We're from Bangor, Maine, and my parents are both very, you know, it's not like we grew up in Beverly Hills or in New York City, and you know, I went to public schools. My parents did parent stuff in Bangor. My dad did baseball stuff. You know, coached and even coached teams that I wasn't even on. You know, and
don't listen, man. The books were always there. They were part of our lives, but so were all the other ordinary things.
Yeah, it was a grounded, fairly grounded life. I mean, when you're, you know, very well off, but still.
Sure,
you know,
yeah, we were ordinary people, for people who eat caviar.
Exactly.
And hummingbirds every day.
We have pet leopards and,
pet leopards, yeah. Right. I can remember you and Joe being up in my office one time and me saying, listen to this, and playing Wavelength by Van Morrison.
Yeah.
You know, and it was like their eyes were open and I thought, I can pass something on. You know,
sure.
That stuff that I thought was Hallmark card bullshit actually happened.
Right, yeah. I think that everything comes from my parents. It's just angled differently.
Let's face it, okay? We've all got a streak of meanness in us, right? We do. We all have the capacity to do mean things, and sometimes those mean things just delight us. I mean, I always say the difference between humor and horror is that it stops being funny when it starts being you.
Yeah.
You
know?
So, exactly.
got time to shoot the breeze. Got no time to blow. Excuse me, mister, if you please. I gotta go. Born one morn on the day of the dead in a bombed out bungalow. My mama kissed my cheek and said, I gotta go.